addition to popular singing, I would like to be remembered as...
Hi guys, this week as promised, I've got a review of all the Redland Bay Bayside skateparks. I also checked the one out in Redland Bay that's under construction, so stay tuned for that one. Go through all the things I like, all the things I don't like, all the sort of safety issues with some of them, and also some of the facilities next to them, like pools, skate shops, parklands, and all that sort of stuff that's around them. So I hope you enjoy this. Check it out. My chain, don't you let my chain, mate. Life of a dog, chain just claws. My chain, don't you let my chain, mate. I'm coming in the club with that fresh shit on. My chain, don't you let my chain, mate. Life of a dog, chain just claws. My chain, don't you let my chain, mate. I'm coming in the club with that fresh shit on.
Me and my team used to dream about the future, but now we be rolling everywhere we go, and our cars never showing. The moment I'm flowing, we living it right now. Long way from the ghetto, pull strings like Geppetto, popping that fine wine. Look at the way my chain shine, soon as I change my state of mind.
Here we are at LOTA, first off the rank. Not much to say about LOTA, it's a pretty flatland park. The bonus is, it does have mounds for the BMX track, so it's not too bad there. It's got plenty of shade. The downfall is the mini ramp doesn't have any stairs to get into it. As you can see, it's just skate your way up to the landing. It is a pretty good one, but with no vert, unfortunately. Yes, other than that, the skate park does have a few other good things there. There is a little mini ramp which doesn't have too much to offer, but it's got a good platform if you want to come up and manual onto it and trick into it or trick off it. But the downside of this park again is it's very flat. There's not much there. There's a little tiny, I suppose you could call it a kicker, mound. There's a pretty fancy Aboriginal painting on it, which does sort of bring a bit of a difference to the park. There's a little rail, and again there's two little grind boxes. Not much else to offer. And there you have your about 1.5 foot mini ramp. So if you're out that way, you probably have the whole place to yourself. Next is THORNSIDE, number 2 on the list. This list again is in no particular order, it's just how I got through them in the editing. Yes, it's a good little walk over the bridge. Again, this park has moderate to good shade. If you wanted to take a dip, you could obviously have a dip in the creek, but yeah, wouldn't recommend it. There's basketball hoop there, which is good. There's good two quarters there with a gap. Another trick box, fun box type setup. There's a fun box there with a grind rail on one side, and also with a grind box on the other side. The downside is, as you can see, there's a puddle in front of one of the quarters, which I don't think it's rained in a good day or so yeah, it must take a little while to drain out of there. The council should get onto that. Yeah, fantastic good art there, which is one thing, and they've done a fix-up job on the concrete, because it is rough as guts and there's lots of little bumps up and down. As you can sort of see, it looks like, I don't know, cobwebs everywhere, but they've ground it down and patched it up, and so it doesn't feel too bad when you roll over with a skateboard. Scooters probably wouldn't even notice at all. CAPALABA, number 3 on the list. Fantastic skate park, has absolutely everything you can think of. A large bowl with a massive wall in it, which is sick for the advanced skater or BMX rider. It's got manual pads, long manual pads, step manual pads, grind box manual pads, you name it, this place literally has it. It's got grind boxes everywhere, ledges downstairs, rails downstairs, square rails downstairs, stairs everywhere, massive ledges. Oh man, it has absolutely everything. It's got a huge drop-in quarter pipe at that end if you're game enough to try it. This massive bowl is awesome. It's 6 foot and I think it goes up to about a 7 foot in the extension. It's got a pretty advanced setup there for the bikers, which is great. As you can see, you've got another set of stairs down to the left there with a rail. That's for probably the beginners in the area. This massive wall there, if you're up to it, it would be a sick launch trick, eh? Or wall ride. You have soccer fields on one side and as you can see it off to the left, you have the football fields, another set of stairs with ran handrails. There's stair handrails everywhere, ledges everywhere, 5 stairs, 3 stairs, 6 stairs, 10 stairs, I think, over the back there. Yeah, here they are here. They're huge, and they're probably bigger than 10. Yeah, you got a little bit of shade in the area. That's probably the only downside, is it's not an overall shady skate park. You've got a lot of sun. But the good news is you've got a local skate shop, Skate Biz. It has all your skating scooter needs you could possibly think of, blower bearing, they've got one over here for you. Yeah, greater range of boards too. So yeah, check them out. I give CAPALABA an all in all 4.5 out of 5 for a skate park. 4 on the list, Cleveland. Here we have a really good skate park. The downside is it gets lots of leaves in there, and obviously, you know, leaves and skateboards don't mix. But you've got moderate shade in the area, fantastic wedge ramp that blends into a quarter pipe, which is absolutely awesome. Running up the wedge ramp into some tail slides, or if you're on a BMX, some pick slides. But yeah, it goes into an extension, so you've got the smaller side and the higher side. You've got ledges, some sick ledges down here, down to the wedge ramp. Unfortunately, it only has them for one side. The other one is, I don't know, it ducks out because of the wedge ramp. Yeah, unfortunately, you can see the leaves in there. Bitumen onto concrete, that's another one. So it feels a little bit ripply, and it's a bit cracky. But all in all, it's a good skate park. The bonus is with this skate park, if you get hot and you're game enough, you can get into the pool. Have a bit of a dip. So there's Cleveland. I give Cleveland a 4 out of 5 stars. Now we're at Victoria Point. Victoria Point is a great park for shade. Unfortunately, the shade causes leaves, so that's a downside to the park. But if you take a broom, it'll take you 5 minutes to sweep them up. Again, it has some of the cracks forming in the concrete. They've been ground down and patched up, so that's great. Some of the local talent here, as you can see, making use of what I can see is actually a really good quarter pipe. It doesn't quite get the vert, which is great for beginners in that sense. And if you wanted to, you can take your BMX or mountain bike. I've seen a few mountain bikers shredding this up, so it's fantastic for that. But back to the skate park, yeah, there's a wedge ramp, quarter pipe, fun box with an up and down ledge on it, and some sort of random bar off to the side that if you're game enough you can have a go at it. But yeah, very flat fun box, which is just perfect for beginners. Victoria State School's just down the road, as you can see they're making full use of it. THORNLANDS, number 6. THORNLANDS is a great skate park. It's got basically everything you need, but on a small scale. It does have a few large quarter pipes and a bit of a large hip there, but it's on the very mellow side, so it's an actually fantastic skate park for getting your endless summer runs, you know, cruising the bowl, you know, do a rail, land into the end zone and come out through the skate park. Yeah, THORNLANDS has good shaded area, moderate shaded area, a small quarter pipe for beginners, a large quarter pipe for a little bit more experience, and if you like bowls, it's got a small bowl there too. So it's almost like having a mini ramp. The overall layout of the park is fantastic. Some of the local talent there showing off their skills.
Skizzy fan, put your hands in the air, put your hands in the air. You a real skizzy fan, put your hands in the air, in the motherfucking air. You a real skizzy fan, put your hands in the air, put your hands in the air, put your hands in the air.
Number 7, Redland Bay. Now, Redland Bay is a great skate park. They're building a new Redland Bay skate park over at the, I guess you could call it Redland Bay Heights. But this one has a decent mini ramp, almost a half pipe with a hip coming out of both sides. And then up the top, it has another mini ramp, which is only about 2 foot, maybe 1.5 foot tall, which is pretty good for beginners, but, you know, it needs something else. Here it is, something else. 1.5 foot of vert on that thing, it is awesome. If you want to get some serious airtime, that's the one to use. Not many skate parks in the area have this, and that's actually fantastic. So yeah, plenty of airtime off that one. The overall layout of the skate park is fantastic. You could play a game of skate with your mate. He could skate down one side, he's got rails and ledges to choose from, and you could do the same on the other side. It's a pretty symmetrical skate park. Very good thought out plan, I guess. It's got, as you can see, moderate to good shade. It doesn't seem to pick up too many leaves. I've been there a few times and it doesn't really get too leafy. I think it's because it's so close to the coast, it gets blown out a little bit. So your little bit of leaves wouldn't take too much. It's not like Victoria Point, which is heavily leaf-litted. Some of the local talent there showing off their skills. All in all, I give this skate park a 3.5. And possibly because it's got medium to good shade, you can call it a 4. It is very small, but it has everything you need. And right next door is your local cop shop. So you must feel safe there. Last on the list, Mount Cotton. Here we go. This is a skate park to check out. It has to be one of the best skate parks I've been to. I've checked out quite a few in Brisbane, and by far the smoothest skate park ever. You come into the place, it's got a nice cool breeze coming off this duck pond. You happen to bring kids or come with friends. There they've got playground facilities, plenty of barbecue facilities, which is awesome. Heaps of shaded areas to check out, chill out in. And if you need to, as you can see at the top there in that dirt patch just above that is your IGA and that. But the skate park itself, it has everything. It's got a bowl section, got a blended wedge ramp with a wall right in the middle of it, with a grind box on top. It's got a rail in the middle, it's got a rail down the wedge ramp, it's got ledges down the wedge ramp. It's got everything. Everything has the perfect contour, camber, everything. The coping sticks out the right amount, nothing's too big. The overall layout of the skate park is very well thought out. Now if you look at it, the white and the black, it looks good. It's a work of art. If you get bored, there's a basketball hoop there, so it's more than just a skate park to check out. As you can see, this guy can get a pretty good run in. It's so smooth, you just roll forever. If you get time to, and you've got kids, you can always go have a play around on the play equipment and get out of the sun for a bit. A fully shaded play area with barbecue facilities right next to it. So it'd be good Australia Day place to check out if you want to go there. Actually, I might go there for Australia Day. Life's too short, fucking up is necessary. Cause one day all these bad women will be married. My Spark drone, I've put on active tracker here. There's not many trees around, there's one on the far side. If you put your drone on this side of the skate park and lock on to your skater, you can actively track the person moving up and down along the skate park without any obstacles. As you can see here, it's doing the perfect job of tracking in, and it's going to zoom back and forward and back and forward. Just make sure you keep them up above the lights and no problems. As you can see, this looks great. It's tracking in fine. It does one more run, not a problem. Just
up is necessary. Cause one day all these bad women will be married.
Smoke clouds in the champagne rain, rain, rain. Smoke clouds in the champagne rain.
Confetti, I don't fear nobody, don't need no money. I showed up for two ducks, one is love, one is honey's DJ, stick this with the needle. Haters, we can't see y'all, probably cause I put my people in all of a people.
So fill my cup, I ain't got enough, I gave my nigga the keys, I'm getting turned up. So fill my cup, if it fill my cup, my cup, my cup. Life's too short, fucking up is necessary. Cause one day all these bad women up.
Hey guys, hope you enjoyed the video. I've tried to make the reviews of all these skate parks as extensive as I could, just all the things I liked and that I didn't, and all the things in the area that I could find. The best skate park, obviously, I feel is Mount Cotton, and CAPALABA was a very close one there, with skate biz being so close. It's really good to have a skate park on hand. Well, the Redland Bay one getting built, that looks very good. There's a few things there that I could sort of pick on, but it looks like it's going to be very good by the same people, I believe, as the ones that built Mount Cotton. So if you like this video, make sure you subscribe and you'll get more of the same. And yeah, for future reference, keep skating, guys. Till next time.